Hey everybody, how you doing? It's Kristen and Dennis. Hey, over here at Lost and Found Mercantile. We're exclusive Dixie Belle retailers in Western Mass. And we're here today, I'm gonna talk to you all about sealing a piece of painted furniture. So what we did here is, this is an old dresser and fluff is on the outside here. We got vintage duck egg on the inside. And the top we did in coffee bean. It's like a really rich, dark chocolate. Like an espresso bean, and it looks great on hutch tops and dresser tops and tabletops and all that good stuff. So we're gonna seal this with gator hide. We're gonna go over that and we'll do a coat of that. And then we're gonna seal this with white wax, which works great over white furniture. I love using the white wax over white furniture. It just adds another richness to it. It's awesome. Okay, so one thing with the gator hide. I learned from one of the brand ambassadors, Malia Klein, Mustard Tree Market, that she uses a coat of flat top coat first, and then she uses gator hide. So that's what I did. This is the flat top coat. I did one thin coat a couple hours ago, and now I'm gonna tint the gator hide with the coffee bean, and we're gonna put a coat on, and then we'll do the white wax. So when you come on, let us know you're here. Oh, hey, Jenny, how are you? Say hello, let us know you're here. I'm gonna do my best at coming up and answering the questions. So let us know where you're watching from. Oh, we got some music going too. So with gator hide, I like to use a bowl, or if I'm gonna do a bunch over a couple days, I'll use like a lidded Tupperware container, which of course I don't have today. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna pour some gator hide into this bowl. And then I'm gonna tint it. And you don't have to tint it, but it just adds a richness and a depth to it. I have these pre-measured out for classes, so I had to steal some of my samples for the video today because, you guys, I spilled my huge 32-ounce container of gator hide. It's behind the dresser on the shop floor. And it got all over my boots. So that was interesting, to say the least. I got in a little bit of trouble with Dennis over that one. He's laughing over there. Hi, hey Pam, how are ya? So then I'm just gonna put a little of the coffee bean in there, just to tint it. And then I'm just gonna mix it up till I like the consistency of it. And lots of times I'll do this just on the last coat, on the darker colors especially, but lately I've been doing it on every color. Like we used sea glass in a class a couple weeks ago, and we tinted the gator hide to seal it, and it came out really nice. So it's a great little tip to use, you guys, is just tint your gator hide. Gator hide is really the most durable product out there. It's gonna give you that water resistance that's so awesome for any flat surface, like tabletops, dresser tops, buffets, all that good stuff. End tables, coffee tables, I always use gator hide. All right, that looks pretty good. Nice and rich, right? It almost looks like hot fudge sauce. It's making me hungry. Oh, from North Carolina, how you doing? Nice to see you. I know. So then I'm gonna use the blue sponge. I'm gonna take the little spoon out. And what's great about doing this in a covered container, like a Tupperware, like I'm not doing, is then you can save it and reuse it. So whatever I don't use, I will pour in a jar and reuse it with my coffee bean, because I do like to use coffee bean a lot. So I'm just gonna take the blue sponge. It's slightly damp. Like no water is squeezing out of it, see? And these are great, I love them because you got the little handle on them to grip. And we're at our shop and we're, Dawn is here, one of our shop members. I don't know, she just looked like she brought something interesting in. Like a big sign or something. Oh, it's a curtain stretcher. Okay, so you just wanna get your gator hide nice and covered. I squeeze a little out. I want it covered across the entire sponge, but I don't want it saturated where when I press it down, it will leak out too much. Hey, from Indiana, how are you? Oh my gosh, today is rainy. We're in Massachusetts. It's just one of those yucky days out. Okay, so now what I like to do with the gator hide, you guys, is just do one big motion across. So I'm just gonna go across that all one time. And it's okay that not every little single piece is covered because I'm gonna be doing another coat. So I'm just dipping it in again, squeezing out a lot of the excess, because I'd rather go back and dip it a couple times than press down too hard on my piece and have it drip everywhere and get all leaky. And I go over it a little bit. It's okay to go over it a little bit, don't worry, but I do like to finish with one big motion. And the thing with gator hide or any of the top coats is you want to walk around the edges and make sure they're not dripping. Oh, it started snowing in North Carolina? No way. Oh my goodness. Yeah. You know, winter's really just starting. We all just have to admit it. We're in New England and it can get pretty yucky. It's pretty and all during Christmas and all the holidays, you know, but once Christmas is over, I'm done with winter. I'm ready for spring. And it's really just starting. We have at least 2 months of winter ahead of us. Could be three. Sometimes March is brutal. So I'm just re-dipping it in there. And sometimes I like to do it to music. I do like dancing back and forth. And just make it nice and smooth. And again, I'm not worried about every little spot because it's gonna dry and I'm gonna come in and do another coat. Then I'll take the edge of the sponge, I'll show you guys in a minute, and I'll just go along the edges because I wanna make sure those are covered. I kinda see this piece as a TV stand for some reason. I don't know why. I'm gonna show you the hardware I have. I'm so excited about the hardware. And then you just wanna do that all in one motion and just make sure. And listen, drips happen, and that's okay if it drips. See, I have got enough in there for my next coat, so I'll put some plastic wrap over it, and I'll use the rest of this up off camera before we go home tonight. So we're gonna let that start to dry. I'm gonna show you the hardware. I'm so excited about the hardware, because I think it's really cute. There's a little piece of confetti or something. Aren't these cute little knobs? They're all different, but they're this, you know, all the same kind of color family. So I think it's gonna look really cute. Hi Pam, how are ya? How's everybody doing? What color stain? Okay, that is not stain, it's coffee bean, which is brilliant. It's like, oh, are you okay, hon?
Oh, yeah.
One of our shop members is here. Poor Don, are you sure you're okay?
Oh, yeah.
It's not stain, it looks like stain though, doesn't it? It's coffee bean. I'm gonna show it to you, but I gotta just show you these knobs again. Tell me, aren't these gonna be so adorable? Like randomly on the drawer? Cannot wait. See? One there. All the different blue and white, a little bit of green. It's coffee bean and I have it in a FIFO bottle, but that's true to color, what it looks like. It's a really dark, rich color and it looks like a stain. And what the other reason I love using it is I like to water it down with water and make a color wash, it looks beautiful. If you do a color wash though, you wanna seal your piece first unless you painted it like a couple weeks prior. Otherwise, when you put the wash on, the water will take off your parts of your first color. So now we're gonna start sealing the drawers and the body of it with white wax. Sometimes, oh, March can be, oh, really? Yeah, don't you love coffee bean? Oh my gosh, Ava, you're gonna love it. My daughter is getting married. Oh, congratulations on your daughter getting married. And it is water-based. Yes, it's coffee bean, it's paint, it is water-based. And you know Dixie Belle has water-based stains. The Tobacco Road is a water-based one. And they have the oil-based stains too. Those ones are oil-based though, but in this great coverage, those are incredible. Okay, so we're gonna do the white wax. Make sure there's no questions. You're welcome. Okay, you guys, this is how I like to do wax. I'm not doing a detail wax where I'm gonna use a brush and, you know, do highlighting different colors. I'm using it to add some depth and some protection to it. So I love to use these. You can get them on Amazon. You can get them at the big box stores in the car area. They're car waxing gloves, little sponges. So it's got the little holder there. And you can put it on with this and then you can buff with it. So they're awesome and they're only a couple bucks each. I love them. Okay, so what we're gonna do, hold on. I'll show you in a big drawer. Cause there's no reason for you all to watch me wax this whole entire piece, but I want you to see what the white wax does, or any of the waxes. So the clear wax also looks white in the jar, and it dries clear. This is the white wax. So it looks very similar to the clear, but it's the white. So I just, again, I like to do one motion to put it on, but I like to, like, I'm using a little bit of pressure to rub it in, but not a ton, because I'm gonna let it sit like 10, 15 minutes, and then I'm gonna lightly buff it. And it doesn't require really heavy buffing, like say a paste wax does, that people like will groan like, oh my gosh, I don't wanna wax that piece because it's gonna take me all that effort and my arms are gonna hurt. This is like effortless waxing. And it's water-based, which is the most incredible thing. I can't say enough about besting wax that Dixie Belle has, because with it being water-based, you can do so much with it. You can layer it with paint and the glaze to add different effects. You can, what?
This wouldn't be a good wax for Mr. Miyagi then.
It could be a good wax. It would be a good wax for Mr. Miyagi for him to use.
Yeah.
But have his students using the other stuff to,
right.
You know.
Perfect.
Yeah, that's what I would say.
Sorry for the interruption.
No, and you interrupt away. And it's okay, I just put it on this way. You can circle it on, you know. Because you're going to smooth it out and buff it. I say buffing it, but it's really just wiping it back. And I love the white wax over white. It just gives it a real... I don't know if you can see the contrast with these two drawers right now, but the white just brightens it up and gives it some depth. I love it so much. Can you tell I love the wax? So now I can show you more of the knobs. Like, look how cute this is going to be. They're all a little different, but they coordinate cute. Who doesn't like cute hardware, right? That guy doesn't want to go on. I'm so excited. Yes, I don't have all the bolts off of everything. Look at that one, the little polka dot. That's adorable. I don't want it too matchy, but then I'll put that one down there. Isn't that gonna be cute? Right? Love it. These are adorable. A hardware can really change up your piece. So a lot of the times now, the hardware you get is like that really old, that little scrolly thing with the two things, you know, so it's so inexpensive to update your piece with hardware. All right, so I'm gonna put some more on this drawer. Maybe if I pull it out, you guys can see a little bit more of the contrast. There we go. Let me see if you guys can see that. Are you looking at comments then so I don't miss anything?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
It's hard to tell.
Hard to tell. Maybe if we dim the light. Dim the light a tiny bit? Can you guys see better now how the contrast is? The top drawer to the bottom. It might be hard to tell on camera. But it's a little better without the light on.
Yep.
We'll leave the light down. In person, it's awesome. And you know what else? I'm not afraid to layer this wax, so I'd rather put on a nice thin coat and come back and put another coat on to get that really richness.
I have a question for you.
Yes.
Do you ever have yellow bleed through when you paint something white? If so, how can you prevent that?
Yes, the yellow bleed through happens when you add any type of water product. It can bleed the tannins through, so that's what that is. It's not the product yellowing it, it's actually the water that makes up the product bringing it out of the wood. So it's already there in the wood. So you can use Boss, which will block any bleed through. You can use that first. It's an awesome problem solver by Dixie Belle. If you think your piece is gonna bleed through, if you don't think it's gonna bleed through, you paint it and it starts to bleed through, you can do Boss over it and then put another coat of paint on. The other thing you can do is you could tint your gator hide with the white, but I would recommend using Boss because you want your piece to last and you want to refinish it right. So it really doesn't matter whether it's Dixie Belle or another company. If it's water based, it's gonna cause the yellowing if it's in there in that piece. Some pieces can be stubborn, and we don't know it until we start painting it, and that's okay. And we know how to work with it. Don't let that stop you from painting white though, because like you can use, I did not use Boss on this piece. It's veneer. It's a bunch of different, it was a bunch of different veneer stains. I'm not worried about it yellowing. I think the white wax does help conceal that if it would happen on another piece. Excuse me. But if I paint a piece and it starts to bleed, I will put Boss on because you want to stop it. And then I'll paint it, do another coat of paint. I hope that answered your question. I know it's a common problem, and it's like maybe not when we're expecting, but it happens, but we can always work with it. It's like what I say in our classes here. Older furniture are like people. Like some of it comes with baggage and you don't know what the baggage is, but it doesn't mean you give up on the person. I know, it's so corny. Getting all philosophical here. You just work with it. It's okay. We don't want to see it on the roadside in the dump. We want to save it. And it's better quality than what you can find now anyways, right guys? That solid wood. So I'm just wiping it on. I want to let it sit before I, oh my, I wish you could see the contrast right now between these two. It's awesome. Got a little music going on in the background. I mean, it is Saturday after all. Saturday night. Anybody have any big plans? I know what our plans are. Home on the couch with the dogs.
And the Patriots.
Oh, the Patriots, you guys. Oh yeah, Patriots are on. That means snacks. Patriots equals snacks, so I'm a big fan. The game is on at 8:30 Eastern time, so we will be having that on at our house with a fire in the fireplace, which is always nice. Excuse me, I'm gonna take this out. I left them in so you guys could see the process, but I do like to take them out when I do the body. And you can see how, like, this dresser was in rough shape, which is why I really cleaned and scrubbed the drawers and I painted them. But I did use Big Mama's butter in the inside to treat all the wood and recondition it, and it smells nice. But I didn't do that to the inside of the drawers because they were really bad off, so I just scrubbed them with the White Lightning and then I painted them. So the only thing is, like, usually, like, say I was doing this, not on video, and I would do this in two different days and tape it off, only because I'm weird. But you certainly don't have to. Just be careful that you don't get your white wax on your, the top, you know? And if you do, you can just wipe it right off. Like, I'm getting some on the drawers, but that's okay, because I need it. I can smell the orange from the butter. It smells good. The orange grove. Can you smell it to me? Mm-hmm. Oh, yummy. Big Mama's butter. Let's see, am I missing any questions, you guys? What color did you paint it? That's vintage duck egg. Isn't it pretty? It's just a nice little contrast. So Jenny, the white wax, it looks beautiful over the different colors, like a whitewash, but this is over fluff, so I'm just intensifying and adding depth to the white, so it doesn't really change it that way. I don't know if that's what you're asking. I'm sorry if I'm not answering your question. The other thing I like to do with drawers that I'll do on this piece is if I paint the inside of the drawer, I like to do a little stencil on the inside, either on the side or on the bottom, like depending what type of piece it is, like on the inside, just as a little surprise. And if the customer doesn't like it, they're gonna have stuff in there and they won't see it, but I like to do that. It's just a sweet little detail, and it's fun to stencil, so. I like that part too. Okay, I'm gonna move this puppy over here. Hopefully you guys can still, yeah, you guys can still. Now, the other thing I wanna tell you guys is when you're doing these little detail pieces, like the cutouts down here, if you feel like you're not getting in there, you can use a brush to get, like a little bristle brush, either a chip brush, you can use something like that, or I love to wax the little detail areas with stencil brushes. They're just the right size. They come in a bunch of different sizes, but this will get it in there anyways, and it's a softer application than the bristles, like, hitting it, so I like to use this. That's why. And I'd rather just like, I'll go in there. Hopefully you guys can see this. And who knows, maybe I'll do something to these little details to jazz it up a bit. But it went in there fine in these little details like with this.
So. Hey, how are you?
So that's good. So, just gonna do a little bit more here. I did one side before we came on, just so you guys, like I said, I don't want you to have to watch me wax a whole piece, but I want to start the, when I wipe it back process with y'all. Actually, maybe. And then I'll wait 2 hours before I put the other layer of gator hide on. But it really brightens it up. It's a great sealer too. It cures really nice and hard. It's very durable.
You already say about the inside your eyes, what color you painted them?
Vintage duck egg.
I wasn't paying attention.
Oh, you weren't paying attention?
For a moment, yeah.
I would that ask them answer Dennis Patrick Fody.
Hi Debbie from Michigan.
So yeah, I'd rather put a little extra on. I'll wipe it back in a few minutes. You don't want to leave this overnight before you wipe it back because then it gets to the point where you can't take it off. It gets too hard. So you want to do that within like 20 minutes. You don't want to let it sit overnight. I'm gonna put these back in. So, and let's see. Won't keep you guys long. I'm just gonna wipe back a little bit of the drawer so you guys can see what I'm talking about. And then we'll end the video. Oh my gosh, that would be gorgeous. Would you bend would be incredible. Hi Michigan, how are ya? Some would you bend would be incredible on there, or some molds, it would be really pretty. I didn't on this piece, I kind of struggled with the look of this piece. I painted it a different color first, and with some stripes, and it just wasn't grabbing me. So I decided to repaint it last night. That's what happened. Fluff happens. What can I say? But yeah, some wood you bend would look incredible. You know what one I ordered that I cannot wait to get it? Have you guys seen the birds and branches one? It's so adorable. I really want to do that on the dresser side. I think it'll be adorable. So, but wood you bend's a great product. All right, so I think it's been 15 minutes enough. We are going to wipe this back just so y'all can see what I'm talking about. And I'm just going to use the other side, or I would use another one. Whatever, a cloth. You can use a microfiber towel or a soft cloth, and you're just gonna wipe it back. What is this? There we go. And you're just taking off the excess, and you're working in all that beautiful wax into your porous surface. Seal it up, and it's so effortless. Their wax is so effortless. People who don't like to wax have probably not tried busting wax because it's incredible. So that's it. You can just wipe it back, and it is good to go. Yes, Dennis, are you saying
something? Oh, no, good.
Oh, he's reading sports stuff, aren't you, Denny? Alright, so I'm just going to wipe this back.
Looking good.
See how easy that is, you guys? So the white over white just gives you a little dimension. And I'm going to come back tomorrow and do another little light coat over it. Because I just like to layer and layer. There we go. So you'll know you've put too much on, you guys, if it feels tacky. Like after a couple days, it should be dry. Like this should be dry tomorrow. If you do a piece and it's not dry, then you've probably put a little too much wax on. So you just want to go light-handed and do a couple little layers over heavy-handed. So that's what we talked about today, everybody, the white wax and tinting our gator hide and doing the flat coat first. Hope you guys can see that top, the flat coat first. Oh, I know, it's not a Barbara, you're my girl. I have Bruce on here all the time. Oh, thank you, Kimberly. Oh, you're so sweet. The wax will cure, you know, you don't wanna, if you're gonna paint over the wax, you wanna wait 72 hours. But you don't wanna wait to wipe it back because it'll be dry by tomorrow or even a couple hours from now. You just, and I might put another little coat on depending on how it looks and how it feels to me. But you just don't wanna leave it overnight and then come back and think you're gonna wipe it back because it hardens, so. Or it gets too tacky where you can't then pull it off. You would have to use mineral spirits to remove it and kind of start all over again. So, hey, Diane. So I just want you to see the top, though. So I'm going to take you off before we sign off. Take you off this little thing. Oh, can I take it off?
Yeah.
We kind of, like, use tape and stuff. Maybe I'll just pick the whole thing up. Here we go. So maybe you guys, hope you guys can see the top. So you see how the top is coming along and it looks like stain, but it's actually paint. So I'll do another coat of gator hide on that. And it'll be nice and even. So we tinted our gator hide. All right, you guys. Well, thank you, everybody, and have a great night. And see y'all later. Bye.